Whether you decide to do flipped classes or in general create course material in the form of videos, slides, quizzes and share it with your students and interact with your students, you require certain tools. In this video, we will see what these tools are and how to install them in the Linux operating system. So here is an outline which more or less we will follow in the entire course. Whereas in this video, we will only mention what are the tools needed for this functionality and how to install them. The actual details of the tools we will cover later. So we will see what tools are needed to record videos for pen, using a pen. Like for example, I'm using a pen here where I'm writing nicely. I can draw some figures. All this, how do you do? How do you edit videos? How do you reduce the size of videos because all of us face bandwidth restrictions? The students, if the video size is very large, they will find it difficult downloading it. So you definitely need to work with small video sizes. How do you achieve that? And all this course material you have created in the form of videos, quizzes, PDF slides, where do you upload them and how do you interact with students? So what are the softwares for this and how do you install? Let's see. Before I proceed, I also want to tell a few things. There are tons of tools available for any given purpose. In fact, it is quite overwhelming if you generally browse. We will focus mostly on popular open source where our focus is on free so that everyone is able to create video material and interact with their students. And importantly also that these are simple and user friendly. One other thing is that we have experience with these tools, whatever we are covering. This in no way means that the other tools are bad. It's just that we don't know too much about them. Yet another thing, each tool has tons of features. To cover all the features will take too long a time. And many of these features are probably not even needed for simple stuff. So we will only cover those features which we tend to use often when doing online teaching. To record videos, we will use this open broadcasting software. This is open source and free. It also goes by the name of OBS. It's slightly sophisticated and hence slightly more complex. So for example, it has webcam support, recording screen and so on. A little bit of effort at the beginning. Once you get to know the main features, you should be able to use it quite easily. How do you install the software? Just follow the instructions here. Essentially, there are four commands you have to run at the terminal and these four are listed here. We will also see these installation shortly, how the screens look. And once you install, if you type OBS and at a terminal, it will show you whether it was installed successfully. For now, just close the window. The actual usage of the software we will look at later. This is how you install OBS in Linux. The first command to type is, this package is already there in my machine, thereby it didn't download it and install. If it is not there, it will install. This is an important step. So do execute it. If it is already there, no issue. If it is not there, it will install. The second step is to do the following. So here it's saying press enter to continue. I would like to continue, so I'm pressing enter. And it is just pulling all these required libraries and packages. And after this, I just need to update. And finally install. Yes, I want to continue. So that is how you install the OBS package. As I mentioned, you can do this as well to check whether the package is installed. And if you do this, this screen should pop up. When recording videos, sometimes you may want to write like on a blackboard. For example, You may want to write words, you may want to draw some figures, or you may also want to write some equations where pen support may be essential. One thing I want to emphasize here is that not all lectures will need this feature. If all you care about is underlining some text on slides, you don't really require this pen support. You can manage with the mouse on your laptop itself. But if you want to do anything more sophisticated, like writing notes, like on a blackboard, you will require pen support. So this pen support, if you decide you need, you have to invest in a hardware. In this case, you can buy something called a bamboo tablet. This is an add-on to your laptop. In other words, you require a laptop and you connect this bamboo tablet to it. This is the cheapest solution. This bamboo tablet costs about 4,000, 5,000 rupees. You can see a sample at this URL. When you use a bamboo tablet, one other thing I should mention is, as you write on the tablet, you have to look at your laptop screen for feedback. This requires a little bit of getting used to, but with half an hour of practice, you should be able to write well. In order to use the pen, the software needs to support it. So for example, if you are opening a PDF through Adobe, Adobe supports it, for which you don't really require an additional software, but you still require a bamboo tablet plus this Adobe software. This is something you can use. But if you want notes taking capability, where you want to organize the notes in the form of chapters, sections, pages, there is a software called Zernal. And this software can be installed via these two commands. Again, we will see this installation shortly. And once you install it, if you type this at the terminal, it opens. That way you know whether it is installed or not. For now, again, close the window. We will look at its usage later. So let us see how to install Zernal. So for this, the first step is to do this. Sudo apt update. I have to enter the password. So after this, I just need to install sudo apt install Zernal, and it is going to do the installation. And let me check whether it is installed fine. I just need to type Zernal, and as you can see, it installed fine. So far we have seen how to record videos. After recording the videos, you often want to edit these videos. What does edit mean? You may want to trim out certain portion of the video where somewhere in the middle of the video you didn't do a good job of lecturing. You want to cut that portion, or you may want to add some text to the video because you forgot to tell something. You don't want to go back and re-record it. In which case, you can just add some text to the video to tell what you missed. Sometimes you may have revealed some portion of the screen which you want to hide. So all this is possible through editing. And OpenShot is again an open source free software which you can download. This is available across all platforms, Windows, Mac and Linux. In general, editing software, video softwares are pretty complex. We have explored a bunch of them. OpenShot seems to be the simpler. So that is what we are going to cover. Installation of this requires three commands at the terminal. These are the three commands, one after the other. Note that you have to follow the same order. Again, we'll see how this installation works. To install OpenShot, you need to do the following. This is the first command. Press enter. Then you do a sudo apt update. And then you install OpenShot along with the required libraries. And let's see if So as you can see, OpenShot works and it is installed. After you execute the previous three commands, you can check if OpenShot works by typing this at the terminal. It should pop up, but sometimes depending upon the version of Linux, it may give an error telling some full version is missing, in which case you need to execute this additional command as well. So now you have to execute overall four commands, but some versions of Ubuntu this is not required, whereas in some versions of Ubuntu this is required. So if you face an error, try this command as well, and then after this you try to open it again. OpenShot not only does editing, but it can also help reduce the size of videos. So for example, if OBS, which is used for recording videos, is producing very large file sizes, you can run those files through OpenShot to reduce them further. Typically, you want about 1.5 to 2 megabytes per 1 minute of video. This is what your end goal should be. If you are seeing very large file sizes like 10 MB per 1 minute, means you have to do something to reduce the size. That way OpenShot is a good tool. This is important because if the file sizes are very large, your students will have difficulty downloading your lectures. So once you create videos, edit videos, resize the videos, your videos are all ready. Along with videos, you may also have slides in the form of PDF. You may also have some quizzes. All this you want to share with your students as well as interact with your students. This comes under uploading your content. Here there is nothing to download and install. In other words, there is no software. These are all web-based. One way to do it is through Google Drive. This is very simple, but it does not have many features to effectively manage students. Or you can use a learning management system. We will cover Bodhitree, which is an in-house learning management system built at IIT Bombay. As teachers, we understand what our requirements are. So based on those requirements, we have built it and fine-tuned it over the last many years through feedback from the students and other teachers. So it has many features. It's pretty student-friendly. So through Bodhitree, you can enroll students, TAs, you can track their progress, you can auto-grade quizzes. It provides lab support. There is a discussion forum. There is also an Android app based on which you can view the lectures. So we will cover this tool. Apart from Google Drive and Bodhitree, there are other options also, like you could upload your videos on YouTube. Moodle is another learning management system that is also open source, but these we will not cover. You are free to explore them on your own. I will provide enough reference materials though. So to summarize, all we have seen in this video is the names of the tools and how to install them. So this we have seen, how do you record videos, how to have pen support when recording, how do you edit videos, how to reduce the size of videos, what tools are available for course material upload. In the future, we will dig into each of these tools and understand their operation.